ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
Yes, continuation to the last class. Next part in appendicular skeleton is pectoral girdle. Next part in appendicular skeleton is pectoral girdle. Then in the pectoral girdle totally what are the bones which are present? Means 4 bones are present. Of them 2 are said to be as the scapula or shoulder blade. 2 bones are said to be as the scapula bone, or that's also called as the shoulder blade. 2 are said to be as the clavicles or collar bones. These are said to be as the collar bone. Definitely in the case of the pectoral girdle, 2 equal halves, 2 equal portions are present. What are they 2 equal halves? Means just assume this is the scapula of one side, again this is the scapula of another side. This is said to be as the scapula bone. Means on the dorsal side of the thoracic region, the center is said to be as the thoracic part. This is the dorsal. On the dorsal side of the thoracic region, between the 2nd to 7th rib, between the 2nd pair of the rib to the 7th pair of the rib, whatever the triangular shape of the bone which is present, that is said to be as the scapula. This bone is said to be as the scapula. This is the shoulder blade or the scapula. This is triangular in shape. This is the triangular bone. This is the flat bone. Definitely on the dorsal side of the thoracic region, means this is the thoracic region dorsal side. On the dorsal side of the thoracic region, means this means this is whatever the triangular shape of the bone which is present between the 2nd to 7th pair of the rib, that is said to be as the scapula or shoulder blade. This is the scapula, this is the shoulder blade. Definitely it is a triangular in shape. It is a flat on both the dorsal as well as the ventral. On the dorsal side it is very smooth. On the ventral side also it is very smooth. So that only it is the flat bone. Definitely along the length of mid dorsal, along the length of mid dorsal there is the ridge. On the scapula, along the length of the mid dorsal, means just assume this is the scapula, this is the along the length of mid dorsal. Just assume this is the dorsal position. Along the length of the mid dorsal means like this, a ridge which is present. This is the ridge.
This ridge is said to be as the spine. This is said to be as the spine along the length of mid dorsal side of the scapula, whatever the outgrowth which is present like this, that is said to be as the spine. This is said to be as the spine. Definitely this spine shows the projection anteriorly, that shows the projection to get to form a process. This process is said to be as the acromion process. This spine anteriorly projected to form a curve-like structure, that is said to be as the acromion process. Here also, just as you, this is the ridge. This is the ridge that is said to be as the spine. This spine anteriorly shows the projection like this. This projection is said to be as the acromion process. This is said to be as the acromion process. Again, definitely, this acromion process shows the curving. By that way, a cavity gets formed here. This cavity is said to be as the glenoid cavity. This cavity is said to be as the glenoid cavity. So, due to the curving of acromion process, whatever the curve which is gets formed, this curve is said to be as the, this cavity is said to be as the glenoid cavity. Definitely this cavity is said to be as the glenoid cavity. This part is said to be as the acromion process. This is said to be as the acromion process. In the glenoid cavity, head of the humor is articulated. This is the head of the humor. Definitely this is said to be as the humor bone. This is the head of the humor. This head of the humor is hidden in glenoid cavity to form the shoulder joint. This joint is said to be as the shoulder joint. Definitely head of the humor, this is the head of the humor, is articulated, is hidden inside of the glenoid cavity to form a joint. This joint is said to be as the shoulder joint. This is said to be as the shoulder joint. Definitely shoulder joint is formed due to the articulation of the head of the humor with the glenoid cavity of acromion process. Definitely acromion process belongs to scapula bone. Acromion process belongs to scapula bone. Again, on the dorsal side of the acromion process, a specialized bone which is attached as, which is with two curvatures. This is the one curvature, this is the another curvature. On the dorsal side of the acromion process, whatever the bone which is attached, that is said to be as the clavicle. This is said to be as the clavicle. definitely clavicle bone. Clavicle bone is with slender. It is longer. Longer bone.
Definitely clavicle bone is the longer bone. That is slender means that is with bending. This is the one curve. This is the another curvature. Means that is with two bends, two curvatures. So that only that is said to be as the slender bone. That is the long bone.
Here also, definitely to that kind of the acromion process, this clavicle bone is attached like this. This is said to be as the clavicle. This is the clavicle bone in that way.
Definitely to the acromion process, this clavicle bone or the collarbone is gets attached. Then what is the use of the clavicle? That provide the surface area for attachment of the shoulder muscle, for attachment of the chest muscle. Definitely this clavicle provide the surface area for attachment of the shoulder muscle as well as the chest muscle. For attachment of the shoulder muscle and the chest muscle, this clavicle provide the surface area. Similarly,
definitely on the dorsal side of the acromion process, another process which is present like this, that is said to be as the coracoid process.
Definitely on the dorsal side of the clavicle, another process which is present, that is said to be as the coracoid process. Definitely here,
both the coracoid process and acromion process, both of them are belongs to scapula. Very important neat objective question is that both coracoid process, again acromion process, both of them belongs to scapula bone.
Both of them are belongs to scapula bone only. Then what is the use of these two sides of the pectoral girdles means? They provide the support to the forelimb. This pectoral girdle compulsorily provide the support to the forelimb. In order to provide the support to the forelimb, this kind of the both sides of the pectoral girdle halves are useful. This is the pectoral girdle.
Next one is the pelvic girdle. Next one is the pelvic girdle. Third bone is said to be as the pubic bone. This is said to be as the pubic bone.
This entire is said to be as the one hip bone. This entire part is said to be as the one hip bone. In the single hip bone, again three bones are gets present. Anterior bone is the ilium, this is the largest bone. Second bone is said to be as the ischium. Third bone is said to be as the pubic bone.
Definitely where these three bones are connected with each other at that particular site, whatever the opening which is present, that opening is said to be as the obturator. Obturator foramen. obturator foramen, whatever the opening which is present in the hip bone, whatever the big sized opening which is present in the hip bone, that is said to be as the obturator foramen. Similarly, in this side also, another hip bone is present. This is the another hip bone. Definitely, this hip bone also with the three bony units. Definitely, this is said to be as the here also ilium. This is said to be as the ischium. This is said to be as the pubis or pubic bone. Here also, this is said to be as the obturator foramen. Definitely, on the both outer surface of the ischial bone, on the outer surface of this kind of the ischial bone, one depression which is present, this depression is said to be as the acetabulum. This depression is said to be as the acetabulum. Definitely, this is said to be as the acetabulum. On the outer surface of ischial bone, whatever the depression which is present, that is said to be as the acetabulum. To that acetabulum, head of the femur bone is articulated. To that kind of the acetabulum, head of the femur bone is attaches to form the hip joint. This joint is said to be as the hip joint. This is said to be as the hip joint. Means, head of the humor bone articulated in acetabulum to form a joint that is said to be as the hip joint. This is the thigh bone. This thigh bone head is articulated in acetabulum to form the hip joint. The joint is said to be as the hip joint. In that way, definitely head of the humor bone is articulated in glenoid cavity to form the shoulder joint. This is said to be as the shoulder joint. But head of the femur bone is articulated in acetabulum of hip bone to form the hip joint. So in that way, both the sides of the pubic bones which are present in the hip joint, both sides of the pubic bones which are present in the hip bone, both of them are connected with each other by fibrous cartilage. Ventrally, both the sides of the pubic bones are connected with each other by the fibrous cartilage ventrally. That is said to be as the pubic symphysis. That is said to be as the pubic symphysis. Definitely, both sides of the hip bones, both the sides of the hip bones means pubic bones of the hip bone are connected with each other by the fibrous cartilage ventrally. That is said to be as the pubic symphysis. In that way, two hip bones are present in the pelvic girdle. Each and every hip bone is again with three bones. One is the ilium, that is the largest bone. Second, ischium. Third one is the pubic bones. This is the one side of the pubic bone. This is another side of the pubic bone. Definitely, both sides of the pubic bones are connected with each other ventrally but not dorsally. This is ventral position. This is the dorsal position. Ventrally, both the sides of the pubic bones are connected with each other by the fibrous cartilage. That is said to be as the pubic symphysis. Definitely, in the each and every hip bone, one large opening which is present, that is said to be as the obturator foramen. Again, on outer surface of the ischium, whatever the depression which is present, that is said to be as the acetabulum. In acetabulum, head of the femur bone is gets attaches to gets form the hip joint. Definitely, this pelvic girdle provide the support to the hind limb. Pelvic girdle always provide the support to the hind limbs, that is the legs. This pelvic girdle always provide the support to the leg. Pectoral girdle always provide the support to forelimbs such as the hands. This is the appendicular skeleton. Next to joints. Next one is the joints. Next to continuous topic is the joints or articulates or arthroses. Definitely, joints are articulates or arthroses. What is the meaning of the joint? What is the definition of the joint means? The point where the two bones are connected one with another. The point where the bone is connected with the cartilage. The point where the teeth is attaches to jawbone. That point is said to be as the joint, or that point is said to be as the articulate or the arthrosis. The point where the two bones are connected with each other, that point is said to be as the joint. The point where the one bone is connected with the cartilage, that point is said to be as the joint. The point where the teeth is attaches to the jawbone, that point is said to be as the joint. Definitely, this joint allows various movements, various body movements, for allowing of the various body movements in our body, for walking, for running, for swimming, for jumping. Definitely this kind of the joints are principally useful. Definitely joints are useful to allow various type of the movements of the body, various types of the locomotions also. Definitely this kind of the joints acts as fulcrum during the bringing of the movement. Definitely fulcrum means this is the point, this is useful to transfer the mechanical energy from the muscle to the bone for getting the causing the movement. Means during the movement, at first muscle is contracted. Due to that, whatever the mechanical energy which is gets generated, that is transferred onto the bone through the joint. By that way only this bone is moves to the up. By that way only movement of the body is possible. So means here, for example, if we wanted to lift our hand to up, in this case, at first this muscle is contracted. Due to that muscle contraction, whatever the mechanical energy which is generated, that energy is transferred onto this bone through joint. By that way, this bone starts movement to the upward. By that way, entire organ, entire forelimb is moves to the upward. In that way, for transferring of mechanical energy which is produced due to the muscle contraction to the bone, this joint is acts as the central point, that is said to be as the fulcrum. This is acts as the fulcrum between the muscle and the bone to bring out the various type of the body movement. Fulcrum nothing but center point. It is the central point which is useful to transfer mechanical energy onto the bone to cause the movement in the bone to move hand to the upward. In a such way, this joint is acts as the fulcrum. Again, study of joints is said to be as the arthrology. Study of the joints is said to be as the arthrology. Study of body movements is said to be as the kinesiology. Study of various type of the body movements is said to be as the kinesiology. By the involvement of the joints, whatever the movements which may be occur, such movements are said to be as the movements of study, said to be as the kinesiology. Then what are the various type of the joints which may be present in our body? Means depending upon the degree of movement of this joint, depending upon the degree of the movement of joints, this joints principally categorized into three types. What are the type of the joints? Means types of joints. Joints principally categorized into three types based on degree of allowing the movement of the bones. What are the means? One is the synarthrosis. Second one is the amphiarthrosis. Third one is the diarthrosis. Third one is the diarthrosis. Depending upon the degree of movement of the bones, this joints principally categorized into three types. One is the synarthrosis, second one is the amphiarthrosis, third one is the diarthrosis. Synarthrosis means the immovable joint. These are the immovable joints. Means they may not allow the movement of the two bones of a joint. This joints may not allow the movement of the bone. So they are the immovable joint. They are the synarthrosis. Amphiarthrosis means slightly movable. Slightly movable joints means they allows the slight movement of the bones in a joint. This kind of the joints allows slight movement only. Slight movement of the two bones of a joint. They are said to be as the amphiarthrosis. Diarthrosis means freely movable. Freely movable joints. Definitely this kind of the joints allows the free movement of two bones in all directions also. If this kind of the joint allows the free movement of two bones, then that is said to be as the prelim open joint, that is said to be as the diarthrosis. So depending upon the degree of movement of the two bones of a joint, joints are principally categorized into three types. Synarthrosis, they are completely immobile joints. Ampiarthrosis, they are the slightly movable joints. Diarthrosis, they are the freely movable joints. Again, depending upon the substance which is involved in the formation of the joint, depending upon the substance which is gets present between the two bones of a joint, joints are principally categorized into again three types. Definitely joints also categorized into three types depending upon the substance which is present between the two bones. Substance which is present between the two bones of a joint, based on that again joints also categorized into three types. One is the fibrous joints. One is the fibrous joints. Second one is the cartilaginous. Cartilaginous joints. Third one is the synovial joints. Third one is the synovial joints. Of that, first one is said to be as the fibrous joints. Means in this case, densely irregular. Densely irregular connective tissue holds two bones of a joint. Densely irregular connective tissue, if it can hold two bones of a joint like this, then such joint is said to be as the fibrous joint. Definitely, densely irregular connective tissue, if it is present between the two bones of a joint, then that is said to be as the fibrous joint. Instead of that, hyaline cartilage or fibrous cartilage, if it is present between the two bones of a joint, if this hyaline cartilage or the fibrous cartilage, if it is present between the two bones of a joint, then that is said to be as the cartilaginous joint. Again, between the two bones, synovial fluid is present between the two bones of a joint, then that is said to be as the synovial joint. Just assume this is the one bone, this is the another bone, this is the joint. Between the two bones, if the cavity is present, that cavity is said to be as the synovial cavity. In synovial cavity, fluid which is present, that is said to be as the synovial fluid. Definitely, between the two bones, instead of cartilage, instead of densely irregular connective tissue, if this synovial fluid is present between the two bones, then that is said to be as the synovial joint. Definitely, synovial joints are with the synovial fluid. In that way, in all kind of the fibrous joints, between the two bones, a densely irregular connective tissue is present. In cartilaginous joints, either hyaline cartilage or the fibrous cartilage is present. In synovial joints, synovial fluid is present. Again, when we observe the fibrous joints, fibrous joints again principally categorized into three types. Fibrous joints are of three types. One is the sutures. Second one is the syndesmos. Second one is the syndesmosis. Third one is the gomphosis. Again, fibrous joints are of three types. One is the sutures. Second one is the syndesmosis. Third one is the gomphosis. Again, cartilaginous joints are of two types. One is the synchondrosis. Synchondrosis. Second one is the symphysis. Second one is said to be as the symphysis. Cartilaginous joints also again are of two types. One is said to be as the synchondrosis. Second one is said to be as the symphysis. Third, synovial joints are of six types. One is the ball and the socket. Ball and the socket joint. Second one is the hinge joint. Hinge joint. Third one is the gliding. Gliding joint. Next one is the pivot joint. Next one is the condyloid joint. And next one is the saddle joint. Next one is the saddle joint. Definitely synovial joints are of six types. Ball and socket joint, hinge joint, gliding joint, pivot joint, condyloid joint, saddle joint. Again of that, first type of the joints are the fibrous joints. First type of the joints are the fibrous joints. Definitely fibrous joints are of three types. Of this three type of the joints, first type of the joints are fibrous joints. Means between the two bones of a joint, there is irregular connective tissue. If it is present, then that is said to be as the fibrous joint. Definitely density irregular. Density irregular connective tissue. Density irregular connective tissue. If it is present between the two bones of a joint, then that is said to be as the fibrous joint. Definitely fibrous joints are of three types. One is the sutures. One is the sutures. Definitely between the two bones of cranium. Between the two bones of cranium, whatever the suture which is present, that is said to be as the coronal suture. This is said to be as the frontal bone. This is said to be as the frontal bone. This is said to be as the parietal bone. This is said to be as the parietal bone. This is the parietal bone. between these two bones, whatever the suture which is present, that suture is said to be as the coronal suture. This is the immovable joint. This coronal suture never allows movement of the frontal bone as well as the parietal bone also. Definitely coronal suture never allows the movement of these two bones. Similarly, this is the occipital bone. This is said to be as the occipital bone. This is the parietal bone. Between the occipital bone and the parietal bone, whatever the suture which is present, this is said to be as the lambdoid suture. That is said to be as the lambdoid suture. In that way, sutures never allows the movement of the two bones of a joint. Coronal suture never allows the movement of the frontal bone and parietal bone. Lambdoid suture never allows the movement of the parietal bone and occipital bone. Never sutures allows the movement of the bones. So that only these are the synarthroses. So that only they are said to be as the synarthroses. They never allows the movement of the two bones of a joint. So they are completely immovable joints. Second type of the fibrous joint. Second type of the joint is the syndesmosis. Syndesmosis is the second type of the fibrous joint. For example, just assume this is the tibia bone. This is the tibia bone. This is the fibula bone. This is said to be as the fibula bone. Between the tibia and the fibula bone, whatever the membrane which is present, that is said to be as the interosseous membrane. Between the fibula bone and tibia bone, whatever the membrane which is present, that is said to be as the interosseous membrane. This interosseous membrane allows light movement of these two bones. Definitely this is the tibia, this is the fibula. They allow the light movement of the two bones. So that only this interosseous membrane which is present between the tibia and the fibula is said to be as the syndesmosis. This is the amphiarthrosis. This interosseous membrane which is present between the fibula and tibia bone of shank allows slight movement. So that only this syndesmosis is said to be as the amphiarthros or slightly movable joint. Better example for this syndesmosis is nothing but interosseous membrane which is present between the tibia and fibula bone. Between the tibia and the fibula bone, whatever the interosseous membrane is present, that is better example for this syndesmosis. Again, this interosseous membrane allows the light movement between the tibia and the fibula bone. So that only that is the amphiarthrosis.